Today we are going to see about in the big data analytics the Hadoop architecture and the concepts of HDFS and the map reduce execution. So what are all the algorithms used for map reducing, that is also discussed. The HDFS concepts has the file system, which is called the distributed file system. It is the primary storage system where the Hadoop applications are using. So in the distributed file system, it provides the high performance access to control all the data. So in Hadoop, we have the clusters. The data across the Hadoop clusters will be accessed with a high performance so that the distributed file system will have all the data stored onto it. Features of HDFS will be, it is suitable for the distributed storage and the processing, and the user interface and the command interface to interact with the HDFS is very easy, and the built-in servers of name node and data node help the users to easily check the status of the cluster. So here HDFS, that is Hadoop distributed file system, provides the file permissions and the authentication, so that the name node only stores the metadata and the directory tree, which will track all the file across the cluster, so that the data directory will have all the files in its file system. The data node will have the stored data actually onto the data node. The block is nothing but the minimum amount of data where we can read and write is called the block. These are all coming under the architecture of the HDFS. Those are all called name node, data node, and the block. So the name node does the following tasks. So what are all the tasks of the name node? One, it manages the file system, and it regulates the client's access so that the client will access all the files. It controls it, the name node. And finally, it executes the system operations like renaming the file, closing the file, or opening already existing files. It accesses through the directories. The data node contains the read-write operations. By the client request alone, it can access the read-write operations of the file system. It performs the operations like block creation. Block is nothing but a set of data. And deletion of the block. It can also create the replica of the files. It all are based on the instructions of the name node. So data node depends on the name node's instructions. The goals of the HDFS. Actually, the fault detection and recovery is the first goal of the HDFS, where the quick and automatic fault detection and recovery of file system will be done. Huge data sets are the second goal. We can access, as the big data tells us, we can access huge data set by number of organizations, so that the HDFS should have number of nodes to manage the applications, so that applications include number of huge data set. The third one is the hardware at the data. I may request a task that may be done efficiently, so that when I complete my task and the computations, it based on the data alone, so that the requested task is repeated and when the computation takes place near the data. So especially the huge data sets are involved in such an computations, the network traffic will be reduced, so it increases the throughput. This shows the HDFS architecture. From the client, we can have the name node access to the block operations on the data nodes and also to the name nodes. The read-write operations will be done on the metadata. So, like name, replicas, etc. will be done with the help of metadata, where it will be placed on to the rack 1 and rack 2. So, the large-scale file systems include our chunks of files which are called master node and name node. So, the directory of the whole file system knows where to find the replicas. Already we discussed about the Google file system and the Hadoop distributed file system. Also includes the cloud store, an open source DFS. So that for further queries, please do mail to the following Gmail ID. Thank you.